PeopleSoft HCM now enables you to troubleshoot global payroll and absence management elements resolution with improved user experience and advanced capabilities. You can select a calendar or segment to get the list of elements that were resolved during the calculation. Your users can review the element's values, definitions, slice dates, and resolution order for each of the traced calendars. You can focus on the resolution of one or more elements by filtering the results. With the Element Trace Extraction tool, you can download the audit details and upload the file in a different environment. This feature lets you identify and analyze differences in the element's definition between your current environment and the database used to extract the trace. Additionally, you can mask sensitive data. You can use the Element Trace Viewer to analyze calendar elements calculated with trace in the global payroll and absence processes. You can also view traces extracted from a different database and uploaded into your current environment. The Element Trace Viewer uses the same audit record as the element resolution chain. The improved user experience and advanced capabilities of the Element Trace Viewer make it easier to troubleshoot or review elements. This fluid component is divided into three sections. The header section contains employee and calendar group information. The left pane is collapsible and lists, in descending processing order, the available calendars and segments in a calendar group. The right panel provides details about the calendar or segment and its elements. Let's take a look at the segment calculation. Click the information icon to view the segment details. You can view the details of the segment such as pay group, run type, segment dates, gross, and net result value. You can navigate through the elements in different ways. First, you can scroll in the element index grid until you find the element you're looking for. When you click the element name, you'll get the details of the element and the associated sections. The most frequently used sections of the element type are expanded. You can expand any other section to get more details. For example, you can expand the Other Updated Elements section to get the list of elements, such as accumulators, that have been updated during the calculation of this earning. In the Additional Element Information section, you can find system elements, dates, formulas, or any other element information that was calculated while executing this earning. You can also navigate by clicking the element name of available elements. You can continue navigating by clicking any other element name. Formulas allow you to view the element name and its value side by side. This helps you to determine whether or not a condition is met. Each element used to resolve the formula is displayed in a different color and has a hyperlink so that you can drill down to figure out how it was resolved. This makes it easy for you to view the resolution path taken, as well as the values for each of the elements used during the resolution. You can even drill down to another formula used in the resolution by clicking on it. Next, click on the Related Actions button. If the trace was created in the current environment, you'll be able to edit the selected element in a new browser tab. This page displays the details of the formula you selected. Notice the breadcrumb at the top. The breadcrumb from the third position lists all the elements you have viewed. As you click on an element, the information on the right pane refreshes. The element in the third position is known as the inquired element. The second element in the breadcrumb refers to the section in which the selected element was invoked. It also works as a filter. You can click on it to view a list of the elements that belong to this section. The first element refers to the process list for the segment. It works as a home or a reset button. This also resets your lookup history. Next, let's extract a trace to view, debug, or compare elements in a different environment. Extracting a trace helps to troubleshoot and compare the element definition used during a resolution against another environment. Once you have identified an absence or payroll process, you can extract a trace. Open the Debug and Tuning Options page. Select the Trace checkbox in the Debugging section and list the employees and calendars that you want to include in the extract file. Note that the Extract Trace option is only available when you have turned on the Enable Advanced Trace options in the Global Payroll Installation Options component. On the Process Monitor page, click on the Global Payroll Payee process. Next, click the Global Payroll Pay After process. Next, let's see the log of the trace. Now, you can download or extract the trace to your local system. Next, let's see how to attach trace files in a target environment. You can attach multiple trace files, but you can only use one at a time. On the Load Element Trace page, enter a name and click Attach to browse for the file downloaded in the previous step. Once you have attached the file, you need to upload it to start viewing the trace in the Element Trace Viewer. You can also delete the trace ID if you don't need it any longer. Click OK in the new message window. Click on the Load link to initiate the upload. This message indicates that the process will replace any previously loaded data. Just one trace ID can be loaded at a time. All features from the Element Trace Viewer are also available for loaded element traces, except the Edit Element action. Instead of editing, you can compare the element definition with one in your current environment. Note that the employee ID from a loaded trace is masked. You can only see the last two characters of the original employee ID. Any other global payroll element set up in the Define Elements Masking component appears as masked as well. Element Trace Viewer provides the ability to filter by element name. On this page, search for the element or elements that you want to review. The search result shows all resolutions where the selected element is used. A plus icon on an element means that you can open it to get step-by-step details for the calculations. You can compare an element definition from a loaded file. Changes to fields are identified with a blue circle. The first value, the one that is crossed out, is the field definition in the current database. The second value, the one that's newly added, represents the field definition from the source database. You can easily identify changes to the element from one database to another. Element Trace Viewer is a powerful feature that allows you to review elements traces produced in the current environment or extracted from another one. You can mask sensitive data using the Define Elements Masking component. You can edit an element for traces produced in the current environment or compare the element definition across environments. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.